Okay. Long time?
Does it take a long time to draw a whole book?
Does it take a long time to draw a whole book? It does. It takes an entire year to draw a whole book. Which is, I guess that'd be a long time, a whole year. And it takes me probably about, you know, a good 3 months of that to figure out how, you know, to lay out the book, and to write it, and then a few months of penciling it, and then a few months of coloring it, and then a month or so of editing the book. It's a long time, but it's fun. It goes by quick.
Cat.
How did you come up with the idea about cats talking and in charge?
Cats talking and in charge. Well, I have two cats of my own, and they are pretty much in charge of our house, so that wasn't much of a stretch.
You're dressed as Cyberman.
And the talking part, I think, was pretty much kind of a nod to Kiki, which is my favorite Miyazaki film. I love Gigi, and I love that he talks. So I can't be certain that's where it developed, but I'm pretty sure in the back of my subconscious I'm thinking, yeah, cats should be talking, that makes sense. I don't know why in my head, but that makes sense, and it's probably because of Kiki's delivery service.
How many?
How many?
Books.
How many books will there be?
How many books will there be? That depends on if people keep reading Cleo. There'll be, right now there's going, I have the second book done and I'm working on the third one. I have about 6 books written, planned out. And then we'll see what happens from there. But yeah, there'll definitely be, right now there'll definitely be at least 4 books. So.
Research? Egypt.
Did you do any research about Egypt, or did you just make it up in your head?
I did do some research of Egypt. Anything that's sort of related to Egypt or the mythology surrounding Free Time Clear was all researched. I didn't make most of it up, but a lot of the things that are in there have kind of a sci-fi twist on them. So I kind of took things, and it's not completely historically accurate because I've changed things to fit the story or fit the tone of the book. There's a lot of things in Cleo's life I didn't think was very appropriate, you know, for a all-ages story. So I kind of took facets of Cleo's personality that I thought would fit and staying true to what we know of the character and put that into the story. And then some of the fun little tidbits will kind of show up, but it won't be exactly the same as how it happened in history because, again, this is a period of life that I am making up. I don't think she actually went to the future. I could be wrong. I guess we don't know. We'll find out in time as we unearth more relics. We might find some ray guns in there. I don't know, but there's a lot of research involved from various books, internet, things like that. But I'd say a lot of it is also made up just to make the book fun.
As you go along.
As you go along, are you making up the whole story, or are you just, or did you just know the whole story and you already know the ending?
I do already know the ending. I know exactly what happens to Cleo and what everything happens. Before I started the series, when I first started Cleopatra in Space, when it was a webcomic, I did sort of just make it up as I went along, page by page. After about, I don't know, about 15, 20 pages of that, I started really thinking about the story, what I wanted to do with it, where it was going to go, and started planning out kind of the long reaching arc of the character. When I started the graphic novel series, I actually created this whole almost Bible of where I wanted it to go and the different plot points. So now it's pretty planned. I know what each book would be. I have some really detailed plots for each book. I know where it's going to go, how it's going to end. So, but I still leave enough in there as I'm writing each book that I can still have something, you know, kind of comes in my head and I can fit it in there and it works. I can still have fun making some stuff up as I go along. But the core of it is planned.
Very cool. And five, honey.
What did you want to be when you were five?
I wanted to be when I was 5 years old. I wanted to be a comic artist. So I used to draw various characters out of newspaper comic strips like Calvin and Hobbes and Bloom County and Garfield. And I thought maybe I'd do something like that or I'd do something in comics. And I worked really hard at it and now that's what I'm doing. So it's pretty cool.
What do you say, Petey?
Thank you.
Thank you. This was fun.